I hear the speeches, but I'm gonna do my best. There's a drumming. I met your lovely daughter.
Four of my five children are here.
For your five
this
children.
My eldest son. Henry. Henry, this is Oliver.
Hello. Hi.
This is Oliver, my middle son.
Okay, hi.
This is firstly my daughter.
Hi, nice to see you.
My daughter. It's my eldest grandson. This is Erin. We got them on camera. Carmen.
Carmen, my darling, how are you?
Carmen was an occupant Borkum. Now she's here on the march. She's fair. Is the Borkum's Borkum.
Some noise at the end of the.
And they're all here on the march. I'm so proud.
Okay.
Thank you.
Actually, later. Okay, guys, we'll see. It's a. My God, it's dropping off. I can do more with it. Okay. Hey, that's okay, put it this way. Sorry.
NHS, proper pay, proper working conditions.
is non-privatised, no closures, meaning over a million people. This year, or maybe at the end of a year, it took 1 year for what they call the Ottawa process to get the anti-landmine treaty, right? So let's work for a year to close down our and other nuclear weapons places. No more nuclear weapons. Let's go for it.
That's popular.
Nuclear weapons are similar to landmines. They got one purpose: to kill as many civilians as possible. I'm so proud of you today. And Jeremy, Nicholas, and everybody else, all of you. Thanks. We know that our government here in Westminster, Trident, our message to them is we're not having that. It's great to know that we have other governments on us, and none more prominent now than the government of Scotland. And so, First Minister of Scotland, Nicola Sturgeon.
Even the
we face in the world of truth, and that's that. Trident does not protect us from anyone.
In the Scottish most clearly and with such pleasure from the campaign was getting that anti-Trident, anti-austerity message out there so clearly. And so it's great that our next speaker is one of those great women leaders, Leanne Wood, leader of the Party of Wales.
Greetings and solidarity from Wales. It gives me great pleasure to march along so many people. Some values that we should hold on to. Peace, through war, through instability. It is never acceptable, ever, genuine destruction on a population. The UK is a signatory to the nuclear non-proliferation treaty.
Serious about be massively investing in the economy and the wealth of the world. With this decision, let us not forget the just one Trident nuclear submarine is carrying enough kill power to kill more than 10 million civilians. More firepower than all the weapons today. And that's why you're here today. And I just want to say that it does make a difference. When I look at you, she's on her way. Thank you very much.
Next speaker is, in my opinion, the most powerful voice in the trade union movement against Trident. Please welcome Mark Watson.
Woo!
We receive a huge amount of support in our campaign from the faith communities across our society, from Christian and a whole range, totaling in some millions and millions of people. And I'm delighted to say that some leaders of those faith communities are with us to the stage together. We're going to welcome Bishop Stephen Cottrell, who's Rachel Lampard, representing the Methodist Church, Paul Parker from the Quakers, Mohammed Koskar from the Bush Association of Britain, and the Reverend Nagasi from the Buddhist community. Invite Bishop Stephen Cottrell to speak to you first. Welcome, Bishop Stephen.
Okay. I bring you greetings from all the faith communities of this land, Christians, Muslims, invited here in saying that we have faith in God, but we have no faith in Trident.
Nuclear weapons no longer have a place in our world.
Blessed are the peacemakers. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And as the prophet Isaiah dreamed of swords being turned into plowshares, let us turn nuclear weapons into hospitals and schools. Why? And I speak as a bishop in the Church of England and a member of the House of Lords. You don't get more establishment than me. Why? Even the Church of England, not necessarily the most radical body one could imagine, in 2007 passed a motion saying that Trident is contrary to the obligations under international law that our country has signed up to. Other faith leaders have said more, but let me give the last word to Scripture. I want to quote to you from the prophet Isaiah chapter 52 and verse 7, and I'm doing my own slightly paraphrased version. How beautiful on the mountains, how beautiful on the streets of London, how beautiful here in Trafalgar Square, how beautiful in every village, town and city in our land.
Ensure that all states make good their commitments to negotiations on the universal, legally verifiable and enforceable elimination of nuclear weapons. We call on all nuclear weapon states, and that includes the UK, to join in this endeavour. We urge these states and the international community to develop a robust plan of action that will lead us to a world free of nuclear weapons.
Thank you.
very much indeed for your support across the faith communities. It's wonderful to have that level of real, strong, solid support. Now, I know that over the past few days, some of you may have been following what I could call spats in the media about whether the leader of the Labour Party should or shouldn't come along to this demonstration today. Some of his MPs saying it's outrageous that someone who's been a lifelong member of CND should actually dare to attend a CND rally. Well, you may have been here on the platform yet, so I'm just going to show you a little message so you know where we're at with Jeremy.
Okay.
Is that ready to come on the screen?
Trafalgar Square. This morning to speak with you in Trafalgar Square on the case for a nuclear-free world. Look forward to seeing you.
So that's our Jeremy. He's on his way. So our next speaker is from the newly resurgent youth and student CND movement. Please welcome Mark Soames. Welcome, Mark.
Thank you. I want to start by talking about the most recent government spending review. Back in November, this spending review proposed that the government should move ahead with a scheme to freeze the repayment threshold on student loans at £21,021. Rather than sticking to their original pledge that the threshold should move upwards in line with inflation, just like the interest on our repayment subs, it means that repayments will start at a lower point relative to earnings, scarcely above London living wage. This is a retrospective change, a unilateral change to a contract imposed on students already paying £9,000 a year, which would be completely unacceptable in any other circumstance. More recently, we faced the news last month that the government are going ahead with plans to scrap maintenance runs that help 500,000 of the poorest students through university and to replace them with yet more loans. And shamefully, this was done by using a statutory instrument to put it through a legislation committee rather than letting it stand up to parliamentary scrutiny. These cuts to maintenance grants will leave students from the lowest income families £12,500 deeper in debt, on top of the average £40,000 of debt. And in other areas of education, last autumn spending review announced that student nurses' bursaries will be scrapped, and a further leak from last month suggested that they can save the social work first. But why am I talking about cuts to education at an anti-nuclear demonstration? The fact is that nothing ever happens in isolation. While the government claims that there's not enough money to fund education, to help the poorest students, to help bring us more nurses and social workers, there is inevitably enough money to fund a new weapon of mass destruction. A weapon designed for and that can only be used for indiscriminate killing of innocents and civilians. A weapon that it would be illegally built under the non-proliferation treaty and that it would be against international law to ever use. It's an anachronistic weapon designed for the Cold War and a superpower, when we're no longer in a Cold War and we're no longer a superpower. Yeah. It's the equivalent of walking into a room with a loaded gun. It's the ultimate overpriced immoral delusion of grandeur. It's unethical, unusable, unjustifiable, and we don't want it. Thank you.
Okay, good speaker there.
If you look at the breakdowns of the opinion polls against Trident replacement and against nuclear weapons, the young people, the younger generation, are overwhelmingly opposed to Trident. So the good sense is coming from the younger generation.
Okay, guys, keep tweeting this and sending this out.
The more the merrier. Closely in its anti-war campaigning, with two organisations in particular, and one of those is represented by our next speaker, Raghad Sikriti from the Muslim Association of Britain. Welcome, Raghad. Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, peace to you all. Trident is a program above the people and the country. Ourselves for further cuts that will affect the working class, the lives of millions of British people. Yet, there seems absolutely no issue with coming up more than £100 billion to revamp Trident. On the security front, spending millions of pounds on upgrading our nuclear capability when we are passing on the nations never to possess improved security and stability around the world. If we were serious about spreading peace and stability, we mustn't proliferate peace. We mustn't proliferate threats and make other nations feel the need to weaponize themselves. The actions of our government is absolutely contradictory to everything that it claims. At a time when society is being divided by failed economic and social policies, by scaremongering, by the rise of racism, fear and Islamophobia, and large sectors of British society are feeling fear of other sectors of the society, the government thinks that by spending such incredible amounts of money we claim we don't have on nuclear capabilities, with security and prosperity. How deluded can a government be? We have seen that terrorists are not threatened or deterred by death or destruction. On the contrary, they thrive on destruction, which makes Trident of no threat, but maybe even an attraction. Terrorists have no land, and they appear in the fragments of weakened and vulnerable societies alongside the many innocents. The Muslim Association of Britain stands firmly alongside the campaign against nuclear disarmament and all groups and campaigns that wish to bring real peace to the world by ridding it of the most destructive weapons man has ever known, and welcomes the public and unequivocal support this movement has from the leader of the Labour Party, Jeremy Corbyn. Isn't it absurd how he has attracted criticism from various corners for saying that he would have pressed the nuclear button? Yet, no one seems to be questioning the sanity of those who support officials who claim that they would readily press the button, which would arguably bring about the downfall of mankind. And has been regarded lately by the mindless few as a passive terrorist. I stand here calling to stop this terrorism. I say that we need to build a safer and stronger Britain. I say no to nuclear weapons and yes to world peace. Thank you very much. Campaigning, an organisation that is now standing together with us in our anti-Trident work, is the Stop the War Coalition. It's a great pleasure to welcome their convener, Lindsay German, to the microphone. Welcome, Lindsay. Because we can.
function. One of the missiles has 8 times the force of the bombs that were dropped in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And look at the terrible, terrible consequences of that back in 1945. We're told that we need Tridents. Our government is embroiled in wars across the world. That the war on terror, which started 15 years ago, is still continuing in Afghanistan, in Iraq, in Libya, and in Syria. Today is a day to mark solidarity with refugees. Yeah. Haven't they noticed? Because when you have nuclear weapons, you also develop more and more hideous weapons. These chemical weapons, these biological weapons are being used against people across the world. And as far as I'm concerned, I don't believe that anybody should have to suffer the threat of nuclear war. We should have to this as something that they put up with. And when David Cameron says he would press the button to start a nuclear war, then I only can wonder what kind of planet he thinks we will live on if that happens. Because it will be the destruction, not just for a few thousand or a few hundred thousand, but and we cannot allow that to happen. Jeremy Corbyn will be speaking here today. I am very, very proud that we have a leader of the Labour Party who opposes wars and who opposes nuclear weapons. Safe. That just simply is not the case. We are making the world a more dangerous place. They say that Jeremy Corbyn shouldn't talk about war and nuclear weapons because he should stick to domestic issues. But Trident is a domestic issue. It's about our safety. It's about our security. Money at a time when we're privatising the health service, when we can't afford to pay our junior doctors, when we're cutting the bursaries for student nurses, and where every local government is making cuts which are damaging the security of everybody's lives. Nuclear weapons. I'm fighting against that which is put, we can't get rid of Trident because it would cost jobs. Surely it is not beyond the wit of people in this country to find jobs for the skilled engineers and the other people who work on Trident, doing something and producing something which would be useful to the people of the world and not destructive to the people. Which will benefit humanity, not make it a more dangerous place.
Congratulations, Lindsay. We can confirm the point that political support for our campaign comes from political leaders in every part of our country. I've just received a message from the Deputy First Minister of Northern Ireland, Martin McGuinness. And he sends this message. I would like to send solidarity greetings to today's CND demonstration. The Tory government in London is planning to spend £167 billion on replacing Trident nuclear submarines. The Tory cabinet of millionaires is doing this at a time when they are punishing the poorest in our society through austerity cuts. This is nothing but an expensive vanity project. The huge sums of money earmarked for Trident would be much better spent protecting the most vulnerable, investing in frontline public services and growing the economy. Plans to replace Trident and other proposals for increasing military spending while cutting public services show the Tories' complete disdain for the lives of ordinary people who are trying to make ends meet. Trident serves no purpose for the people of this country, struggling as a result of Tory austerity policies. Thank you. First went on a CND demonstration in 1983. It was a big demonstration of maybe 500,000 against cruise missiles in Hyde Park. And I remember standing in the crowd at the rally at the end and looking up at the stage, the dot on that stage addressing the crowd with enormous passion. And I'm delighted to say that I can welcome that same person to this stage today. Please welcome Bruce Kent.
Hey guys, if you just like the video, it actually helps us and keep tweeting it out. Thank you.
She was a mere little girl then. She was about 12 or 13 years old. Very good looking. And I think she's done very well. Give her a good cheer. I'm here to represent the ancient pensioners of the world. There may be one or two other people here, ancient pensioners, because we people have gone before you in lots of ways. Amazingly, we're still alive. Some aren't, and I'd like to give you a name tonight, someone to whom we owe a great deal, the physicist from Poland, a refugee from Nazi Germany, really, Joseph Rotblat, who came in 1944 and went to work on physics in Los Alamos on the first bomb. And when he discovered they were going to use it on Japanese cities, he said, not with my help, and he refused. That was a moment of importance in the world, because a leading scientist said no. And all the other people who've gone before us, give them a good cheer. I don't think those proposing nuclear weapons have any good arguments whatever. We go back to Ernest Bevin, and he wanted them with a bloody great Union Jack on top. And that kind of stupid nationalism has been running ever since. Let's give Ernest Bevin a good boo. Thank you very much indeed.
There are no arguments for nuclear weapons. There's every argument for getting rid of them. And I'm happy to say I'm a bit of a delinquent member of my own church, but I'm a great fan club of the new Pope Francis. And Pope Francis has... He's got a lot in common with Jeremy Corbyn. Let me give them a cheer as well, both of them. I'm not here just to go on the someone will pull my coattails in a moment, but I'm really here to squeeze you. I don't mean in a personal way, but I really squeeze you for money, for cash. None of these things happened by accident. The other day I bought a bus with over on the advertisement saying, come on the demonstration. They don't go up for nothing. On the underground advertisements, they don't go up for nothing. We've got here some very big bins. People go around with buckets. People have already, I know, been immensely generous. I spoke to a woman today who'd come down from Kissing or somewhere with electricity. £65 to come down. That's brilliant for that money. So I know people have been very generous. I ask to squeeze you just a bit more. And perhaps, if you've got a rich party, put in an IOU on your auntie's name, £100 or £50, and go back and tell her. She'll be pleased, I'm sure. All those rich aunties stick an IOU in the bucket. Be generous now. The issue is too important. We are the very edge of beginning nuclear disarmament around the world. Don't let's lose this moment. Thank you very much indeed.
Sorry guys, about the helicopter. We don't know if it's police or the BBC, but it's damn annoying.
Right now, many people have mentioned what Trident, the money for Trident could be spent on instead. We've heard about the education, jobs, all different kinds of things that would be useful for our society. And of course, above all, we've heard people talk about the National Health Service, something that affects all of us. From cradle to grave. And so it's a pleasure to welcome our next speaker, who's a student nurse and particularly active in campaigning to retain those bursaries that are so essential to provide for those student nurses. So please welcome Danielle Tiplady. Hello everyone, it's really, really great to be here with you today. I'm so nervous. I'm a student nurse at King's College in London, and in November, George Osborne disgracefully cut the NHS bursaries for healthcare students. NHS students work incredibly hard. We do 2,300 hours clinical placement. We work nights and weekends, 12 and a half hour shifts. I've been a privileged student nurse who's held a patient's hand in the last moments. I've been the who's spent the day comforting and supporting the family, the one who gets the tissues, the one who hugs and consoles them in my arms at the loss of their loved one. George Osborne, you should resign now. So here we are, and I'm standing here defending the training of the future workforce of the NHS, when the Tories are renewing Trident, which could fund 2.5 million student nurses through their training. The bursary is not a cost, but an investment in every single one of you. The Tories are destroying, ripping apart, and chewing up our NHS. Jeremy Hunt is not a fool. His advisor is Simon Stevens, who is heavily linked to private healthcare. And let's not forget Jeremy Hunt wrote a book about privatising the NHS. He's imposing unsafe and unfair contracts on our doctors. He's risking people's lives. Jeremy Hunt, you need to resign too. Yeah. In 2014, the government made 1.1 billion cuts in social care. Elderly people are living alone. Also in 2014, there was a 27,000 rise in the amount of deaths. Elderly people deserve our respect and help. Shame on you to the Tories for making
deal. Since the cuts to the fair freeze, I've been leading a campaign. We've demonstrated with 500, we've protested with 5,000. I also had the pleasure of meeting Ben Gummer, who's Jeremy Hunt's sidekick. And you know what? He should resign too. On the 16th of April, the March for Health, Homes, Jobs and Education. This is so important for the NHS. It's during the bursary consultation, and I really would like you all to be there with us. I say NHS, not Trident. Nurses, not Trident. And you know what? It's not just Jeremy Hunt, George Osborne, and Ben Gummer who should go. They should all go. Tories out now!
Sometimes we may feel as though we're up against it here in Britain with our anti-nuclear campaigning. We've got a hostile government, what often seems, I'm sorry to say, like a hostile media. But I can tell you that we have it easy in our campaigning compared to what people face in some other countries. And I think no more so than with our next speaker, Sharon Dolev, representing the Israeli nuclear disarmament movement. A big welcome to Sharon.
I have to say, I'm extremely nervous. The biggest demonstration in Israel against nuclear weapons had 300 people, and we thought we were robbed. Look at you, it's amazing. I don't believe in politicians because I always thought that politicians lack any courage to make a difference. And it was always obvious to me that it's up to us, civil society. But look at what happened here. While you have a head of opposition and other leaders willing to say the right thing, really the right thing. Cameron is going to push the red button? That's insane. While he's talking about Jeremy Corbyn not able to tap his upper button, Jeremy Corbyn, head of opposition in a huge nuclear state, is willing to say the most sane thing that any leader ever said. I will not push them. I come from a nuclear armed state when actually we're not really allowed to say that we're a nuclear armed state. But that makes us both, Britain and Israel, two of nine states in the whole world that hold the rest of the world hostage for criminal weapons. Nine criminal states that have to ban nuclear weapon, and they have to do it now. One submarine, one Trident submarine, using its weapons will cause nuclear famine, total change in the atmosphere, 70% less of sunlight, and global starvation. The only people that will not suffer will be those who died on the first strike. The rest of us will envy them. How can you excuse almost £200 billion? That doesn't say that Britain is willing to fulfill any of its promises to disarm this weapon. That means that Britain thinks that these weapons are here to stay, but you came here to say no. And that's amazing. You should be extremely proud of yourself. I'm a believer because it takes a believer to work on nuclear disarmament in Israel. And I have to tell you that especially after the week here, I believe that you will stop Trident, just like I believe that we will stop the occupation, get rid of our nuclear weapons, and create a weapons of mass destruction.
say, okay, Trafalgar Square is allowed to take 5,000 people. That's on the square itself. There's a lot more.
At least 10. Passed a motion in support of this demonstration. And here to represent the NUS today is their Vice President, Shakira Martin. Welcome, Shakira.
Hello, my name is Shakira Martin, and I'm the Vice President of Further Education for the National Union of Students. Bringing solidarity from the National Union, representing 7 million students in colleges and universities across the UK. This week, Ethnicity supported today's demo, and it's fantastic to see so many students here today. And I want to say well done to the youth and students, CND, and everyone for mobilising here today. Destruction! There is just one country in this world that used nuclear weapons in history, and that country is the United States of America. They killed a quarter of a million when they dropped bombs on Japan in 1945. Today, our Trident nuclear weapon system, not just a British system, is a part of an international network of nuclear weapons. We are aligned to the only country to have ever used nuclear weapons in history. And that is a disgrace! Are our nuclear weapons about defending ourselves? Or is it about bullying and intimidating the rest of the world? Can you imagine a situation where these weapons will be ever used? Because I can't.
Yeah.
There is a criminal waste of £100 billion. What about the hundreds of millions of pounds being taken away from our colleges, further and adult education? Yeah. Our colleges are going to be destroyed by the disgusting Tory government. The next generation will lose massive opportunities to reach their full potential. These are the people I represent in my community in Peckham, Hackney, South East London. We need education. What about the 40,000 people and 40,000 pounds of debt students are getting just to get a degree at university? What about the financial support being taken away from disabled students? And what about the 3.7 million children living in poverty in this country? One of the richest countries in the world! It's time to do the right thing. It's time for the government to change its disgusting priorities. And that's why it is vital that you come out on the 19th of March to the Stand Up to Racism demo, and to the 16th of April to stand against students' health and education, because this is all connected. And we need you, and you to be on the streets. So let's say, stop Trident and fund our education!
Our next speaker first came to my attention just a few years ago. You may remember when the Occupy movement set up camp outside St Paul's Cathedral to draw attention and oppose global inequality. And for a little while, that was okay. And then eventually, the establishment turned against that movement and their message.
but there was one bright light from St Paul's Cathedral who stood there in solidarity with that movement and eventually resigned rather than betray their cause. So it's a great honour to welcome Father Giles Fraser here today.
He's got his back to us. Can you see up there, right at the top, Lord Nelson? He's having a bloody bad day, I can tell you, with all of you in front of him. He stands for empire, and the empire is what this is all about. Because there are those people who want to cling on to stupid weapons like Trident for ego. For the idea that we are still some great power in the world, and that great power has got something to do with having nuclear weapons. Well, we must say to him, even though his back is turned to us and to his like, we don't want to be that anymore. Woo! We don't find our place in the world because we've got bigger bombs than everybody else. We don't find our place in the world because we have a navy that can kill thousands, tens of thousands, millions of people. I don't want that. You don't want that. Our children don't want that. The truth is, and to be serious for a minute, is that the weapons that are placed on submarines will no longer serve us for the future, just as his ships will no longer serve us for the future. The sea will be full of drones in the next 15 years, 20 years, which will be able to find out where our submarines are. We will be spending tens, hundreds of billions of pounds on a weapon system that will not work. It will not work. It's the most ridiculous thing. Not only ridiculous, but flat out immoral. Who would press that button? Who would actually press that button? Press that button to send millions of people to their deaths. The most disgraceful thing that humanity has ever invented. And we're standing here to say no to that, for us, for other people around the world, for our children. So, Nelson, turn around, listen to what we've got to say. No to war. No to war.
Thanks very much indeed, Giles. The National Union of Teachers is very, very strongly in support of the CND and the anti-nuclear movement for many decades. And their General Secretary, Christine Blower, has been a great activist against nuclear weapons for a long time. So it's a pleasure to welcome her as our next speaker. Welcome, Christine.
Hey, thank you very much. I can tell you it looks absolutely fantastic from up here. Before I speak as the General Secretary of the National Union of Teachers, a job and a union of which I'm very proud, let me just say something personal. When I was a reasonably young person, I was very worried by the Cuban Missile Crisis. And when I became a mother, I was very worried about the futures that faced my daughters. And now I'm a grandmother, I am worried about the future that faces my granddaughter. And let me say this, because I have been worried for so long, I have been an activist and a campaigner for so long, because you can't just worry, you have to do something about it. And with the campaign for nuclear disarmament, and why personally I am associated with Bruce Kent and the movement for the abolition of war. You know, lifetime and before my lifetime. And when I think about the obscenity of the amount of money that could be spent on Trident, I think back to that generation, the post-war generation, the 1945ers, who built a welfare state, a fair state, who looked to health and housing and education and said, that's where we need to put our resources. We need full employment, we need housing for all, we need education, we need health, we need social care. Those are the things that matter. We need a fair society, we need a just society.
Oh my God.
And what is it that draws together the question of refugees, the question of austerity, the question of Trident? It is this. It is that this government is making the wrong choices about all of those things. We don't have to have austerity. It is a choice. We don't have to have Trident. It is a choice. These are the wrong choices. Friends and colleagues who are here today, say it loud and say it clear, because the government has to hear. Say it loud and say it proud. No to nuclear weapons. No to Trident. Let's hear it. No
to Trident.
And don't just be on the streets today. Be lobbying. Be active. A better and different world is possible. And I will make sure that I say to all my friends and comrades in the trade union movement, please don't worry about jobs. If we weren't building Tridents, we would have better jobs. So carry on saying no to Trident. Thank you.
Thanks very much, Christine. Our next speaker is the most inspiring anti-war campaigner across the generations. Please welcome Tariq Ali.
Friends, we should make one or two things clear to the media and to the politicians who continue to mouth lies. There is no such thing as a UK independent nuclear deterrent. There is no independent nuclear deterrent. No British Prime Minister can put his or her finger on the trigger. The finger on the trigger is that of the United States President. That's a fact. The Supreme Commander of the NATO forces, who is always an American general, is the person who will decide when nuclear weapons can be used. Either the Trident missiles or the bombs that are being placed at the Ramstein Air Base in Germany, where 100 planes are permanently on the ready. 60 will be flown by Americans, 40 by Germans. Same in Italy, same in Leighton Heath. So what is all this fuss about? The fuss is really about pretense, because everyone knows. Even Tony Blair said it in his memoirs, that there is no, that common sense tells us that there is no practical or utilitarian or financial justification for the Trident, but we need it because it upgrades Britain's position in the world. Upgrades. I think it downgrades Britain's position. It is seen as someone who supports the United States in all its wars. this that has created huge problems for Britain in the world. If it really wants to morally upgrade its position in the world, it has to get rid of nuclear weapons. And why does this seem possible again? Because some of you may not know that one of the largest movements we had in this country in the late 50s and the early 60s was the campaign for nuclear disarmament, supported by hundreds and thousands of people. 100 Labour MPs were members of CND. Virtually 80% of the constituency Labour parties backed CND. So that opportunist, careerist MPs, when they went for their selection meetings, and I won't name names, but when they went for their selection meetings, they used to put on a CND badge so they might be selected by the Labour Party.
You don't see that anymore.
So what is all this nonsense we hear from right-wing Labour MPs that we can't get elected? What Kinnock attacked Corbyn for today? Kinnock used to be a member of CND once upon a time, then he left it, like many others. Then he became leader of the Labour Party. Then he stood for elections. He didn't win. Why didn't he win? What is that to do with CND or what was being advocated at that time? So we have a real possibility today. When we have a leader of a major mainstream party committed to getting rid of these missiles, which most people agree, including many a retired general, are of no use whatsoever to this country, but are going to cost a lot of money. There is no reason for it at all. And for the first time now in years, these questions are being debated in the House of Commons for two reasons. One is that you have a new leader of the Labour Party. And the second is that you have Scotland coming out strongly against nuclear weapons, and the representatives making that very clear today. You know, the first CND march I went on in 1964, huge numbers were coming in from Aldermaston. It used to be from Aldermaston to London. Aldermaston is where they were specializing in germ warfare. And we used to march from Aldermaston to London. And one of the liveliest contingents used to be the contingent from Scotland who used to chant, Och, there's a monster in the loch. Och, there's a monster in the loch. And we deene want Polaris. And now there's no monster in the loch and they don't want Trident either. Because the monster in the loch has actually shaken the Scottish Parliament and has 50 or odd MPs in the House of Commons. So there is a growing mood for getting rid of the Trident missile. And were we to elect a Labour government under the leadership of Corbyn and his colleagues, there is a possibility that this demand that was first put up in the late 1950s will become a reality. And all of this depends not simply on the political leaders, including the ones we like, but on us. What are we going to do without campaigning against Trident, in defense of public ownership of the railways, in defense of the National Health Service? It is not going to be possible without a campaign to move forward. Because campaigns mobilize people.
Yes.
Debates stimulate people. We live in a society where they don't like debates at all. They don't like diversity, either in the print media or in television by and large. They don't like diversity in Parliament either, but there they can't stop it. And because it exists outside and in Parliament, it can't be ignored. But we have to reignite the spirit of debate. We have to discuss these issues on the shop floor, in offices, on the streets, in home, and then a huge campaign can be developed. A huge campaign which will return a party to power that is committed to getting rid of Trident missiles. That is what we have to do to work for. I want to see Jeremy Corbyn in number 10 Downing Street.
I'm sure we all agree with that, and I'm pleased to say you'll be seeing him on this platform in a few moments. But just before, I'm very delighted to welcome two final speakers. Tariq talked about military sentiment turning against Trident. I'm pleased to say that our next speaker represents a former military organisation, Veterans for Peace, which is very, very strongly opposed to Trident. Please welcome John Bolton. John.
Brothers and sisters, we are told that Trident is a vital component for our national security. This is nonsense. Trident is nothing more than a status symbol, nation obsessed with punching above its weight. We are told that Trident keeps us safe. Ownership of Trident merely puts us on the target list of other nations with nuclear weapons. We are told that Trident prevents war. This from a nation that has been almost continuously at war since it first obtained nuclear weapons. And we're told that Trident provides thousands of jobs. Well, okay, but if the money that's put aside for Trident renewal was spent on building new homes, we provide far more jobs. We're told that Trident gives us independence. Well, this is nonsense, because the United States has the power of veto over our nuclear weapons. This missile system is nothing more than a manifestation of power, US power over us. And we're also told that Trident is safe in our hands because we are a moral nation. Well, arms deals to Saudi Arabia aside, Trident is a genocidal weapon of mass destruction. Its ownership is immoral. Yeah. What is it that I can tell you, standing here today as a member of Veterans for Peace, an organisation comprised of ex-service personnel committed to the abolition of war in the 21st century? Well, I can only hope to appeal to my former brothers and sisters in arms, and I say to them, what's in it for you? For those, what's in it for you? And for those responsible for the maintenance and or the government has at its disposal, what's in it for you? For those out there who still support Trident renewal, if you put aside the political statistics and the economic arguments, and we take a look at what nuclear war actually looks like, what it actually means, retaliatory or otherwise. It means good, honest work, unleashing a terror, a holocaust, an unimaginable and as yet unprecedented horror on other good, honest, working people like ourselves, whom we have no quarrel with, who love their families too, and all on behalf of a handful of people whom none of us have anything in common with. And I can guarantee safely tucked up with their families in their protected bunkers. People, you can't get world peace, you have to be world peace. And everybody standing here today, please be in peace. Let's keep on doing it, let's hope the idea spreads. Thank you.
Thank you.
I think Jeremy Corbyn's going to be coming soon as well. Yeah, but keep sending to Stop the War UK and CND UK.
Now is Rainer Braun representing not only the German peace movement but the International Peace Bureau. We've worked closely with Rainer, particularly in our campaigning against NATO. Please welcome Rainer Braun.
The vote of peace in a national peace movement are looking at you. You are today in the fight against the modernization of nuclear weapons. Congratulations to your great demonstration today. Your struggle for peace and against the modernization of is a fight we all are doing all around in the different countries. Nuclear weapons are against international law, against humanity, against an peace. Nuclear deterrence is a political crime. Together we can overcome the old story of nuclear weapons, of modernization, race and war. We can stop the modernization of truth in the weakest link in the strategy of all nuclear weapon countries in the world. Your actions, your struggles in the past years have turned Trident into this weakest link. And we hear us say, you can succeed. We will support you by enlarging our solidarity, above all, by increasing our fight in our own countries against nuclear weapons. You know that in Germany, between Rhine and Mosel are lying more than 20 UF nuclear weapons. We start 2 weeks ago with a new campaign against these nuclear weapons. We don't want to have UF nuclear weapons in Germany. We want to ban them. We want to be a part of the UF nuclear weapons. And let me say, we are here because we have a vision, a great vision. And for these visions, many generations since 1945 were fighting. And the name of Joseph Rotblat was mentioned. Our vision is a world without nuclear weapons. And this world is possible, feasible, realistic, and reachable. And it is reachable in our lifetime. We are supporting the work of the open-ending working group of the United Nations, which met last week in Geneva. We are supporting the Austrian pledge for humanitarian consequences of nuclear weapons. We are in favor of a banned treaty. But our great goal, our aim, the reality of our visions is a nuclear weapons convention which legally, verifiably, and eternally will ban nuclear weapons from our planet. Your demonstration shows by hard and facts, by emotions and words, a nuclear weapons-free world is possible. Let us continue fighting for this big goal. We can be the winners. No Trident, no modernization. For peace and a world free of war and nukes. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, Rainer. And now I'm hoping the person I'm about to introduce is coming up that staircase through the crowd.
Okay, that's for the Corbynistas, I think he's here.
Our next speaker is a wonderful friend. to CNZ. He's our vice president, and by chance he also happens to be leader of the Labour Party.
Trafalgar Square, as ever, looks brilliant and looks great. Because everyone who's taken part in this democratic future defence of this country has a right to be heard, a right to be on the streets, and a right to make their voice known before any crucial decision is taken. I first joined the campaign for nuclear disarmament, and I'm still a member, only a short time later. CND and the wider peace movement play an absolutely vital role in our society. They speak up for peace, speak up for justice, speak up for human rights, and whilst many of our media will never actually have an enormous effect on the politics of this country. I remember the vote on Syria. I remember the demonstrations over the Iraq war and many, many others. We begin to change that whole narrative. Too often, the debate on nuclear weapons is presented as a cynical set of alternatives that are put forward. X says this, Y says that, Z has an interest in this, B says something else. I think we should just consider for a moment what a nuclear weapon actually is. It is a weapon of mass destruction. If ever used, it can harm numbers of civilians. They've only once been used in war, and that was in Japan in 1945, and we still see the consequences in the cancers and the destruction and the horror of very old people in Hiroshima. And used in testing in the Pacific and other places. The victims in the Marshall Islands are still living with the consequences of those tests. As indeed are people in Australia, the United States and Russia and many, many others. And the now very elderly nuclear test veterans are also paying the price for those nuclear tests in the 1950s, when they were used as guinea pigs while nuclear explosions took place. Sometimes today's generation of politicians all are up in what they think is a post-Cold War age and think that nuclear weapons are no longer something that is a matter. I had the honour of attending the Humanitarian Effects of War conference held in Vienna. I was part of a British peace delegation, and I'm pleased to say at that conference the British and American governments were represented. We were told in the most graphic detail possible by scientists, by nuclear experts, two things. One is how a nuclear weapon explodes, and secondly, what the effects are. The immediate environmental effect, the immediate destruction, the immediate problems of the fallout, the slightly later ecological disaster that follows, the economic impact that follows, the food supply impact that follows from one in one spot on our globe. It would have global effects. If a nuclear war took place, there would be mass destruction on both sides. Absolute mass destruction on both sides of the conflict that took place. I think everyone who is about to make a decision on what we do about our nuclear weapons should think about the humanitarian effects on wholly in this globe if they're ever used. Britain is a signatory to the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty. That treaty came about because, in part, of the work of the Labour government from 1964 to 1970. And before I came here today, I was reading the election manifesto of the Labour Party, which wanted to not renew, bring about a different world. Not all of that was achieved, but the NPT, the Non-Proliferation Treaty, was. It has worked in many ways. Those countries that did not have nuclear weapons, for the vast majority, have not taken possession of them. Whole parts of our globe have become nuclear weapons free zones, Latin America and Africa, for example, as well as Central Asia. It's a credit to the leaders of all those countries on both those continents that that was possible and that was brought about. To the South Africans, Argentinians, Brazilians, and many others. That. And I've attended numerous NPT conferences, the last in New York in May. The Non-Proliferation Treaty has a requirement on the five declared nuclear weapons states to take steps towards disarmament, as it does on the, I think, 187 other states not to possess them. It is a very precious thing. And I want to see a Labour government that will adhere to all of the articles of the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty. So a decision is about to be made. We're not quite sure when. That's a matter for the Prime Minister to decide on whether or not Britain should renew the Trident nuclear missile system. As you know, I stood for election, the leader of the Labour Party, in a dramatic summer of meetings and activities. And I've put forward, not me, a lot of other people, it was a we rather than me style of campaign that we ran. And point six of the 10, if elected leader, I would seek to be replacing Trident, not with a generation of nuclear weapons, but jobs that retain the community's skills. And I'm very serious about this point. They don't want us to replace Trident. Everybody knows that. Many of the British public don't want to replace Trident. I hope there'll be more and more of them who don't want to replace Trident. But that's not a reason to make whole swathes of industry redundant or jobs be lost, to invest in those towns, those cities, those economies and those skills. So those skills are not lost. They're still working, making aircraft, making ships, making all the things and the high technology that goes with it. They're brilliant at. See this as an opportunity for the regeneration of high-tech industries in Britain, not the destruction of them. We can indeed achieve something very much better as a result of what I would hope would be a positive decision that we don't spend £100 billion on the replacement of the whole Trident system and the submarines and the 25-year lifespan that they would have. I would like to see those resources invested primarily in ensuring we have good quality industry behind us, and after that on the dividend we get from peace. We live in a world where so many things are possible, where peace is possible in so many ways and so many places. You achieve peace through democracy, through respect for human rights, through ending inequality, through sharing resources. You don't achieve peace by planning for war and grabbing each other's resources and not respecting each other's human rights. And so how we do these things is very important. I asked Emily Thornberry to become our Shadow Defence Secretary. And I said to Emily, what I want you to do, the first thing I want you to do, and she did it very quickly, straight away, was prepare a document in which there can be the widest possible consultation on the defence and security issues, but above all, include the Trident missile system within that discussion. Politics has to be open, and politics has to be an inclusive process. Openness and inclusion are surely what we are strong about, what we're good about, political change. So I want all of you to make your voice heard. Put your views forward, put your ideas forward, put your suggestions forward, so that there is a growth, a momentum of that support that shows exactly what we think about nuclear weapons and the way forward. That is how we achieve that change. That is how we achieve political change within this country and in the wider world. We are not alone. There are many people around the world that have stood up to be counted, who wanted a non-nuclear future for their country and their planet. Some have suffered grievously as a result of that. Many of us have marched for many years and met for many years with the view that we bring about a peaceful world by arguing peacefully for it, putting forward the logical alternatives and showing to people the horror of war and the total horror of nuclear weapons should they ever be used by anybody. Today's demonstration is an expression of many people's public opinion and many people's views. A lot of people said, well, maybe it's utterly irrelevant, maybe you shouldn't really be there. I want to be here because of my belief in a nuclear-free future. I believe that the result we achieved in that dramatic election last year was about reaching out of a different kind of politics in a different kind of world. A world that emphasizes dealing with the crying needs of the poor and homeless in this country. Those that are going short and suffering public spending cuts in this country, but also a globe in which we address the grotesque levels of inequality across this planet. We solve those by together sharing and working together. We have a serious process of looking after each other by that means. Thank you for coming to today's demonstration. Thank you for showing that you care. And thank you for wanting a peaceful future for this country.
Every strength and success, and it remains to me for coming along today. We have given to our government is a powerful one from tens of thousands of people representing millions across the country. So please keep up the struggle, fight to defeat Trident. If you're not a member of CND already, please join us. It's our time now to defeat this monstrous weapon system. I wish you a safe journey home, and never forget, we are the majority and we will prevail.
Okay, thanks guys, and please, if you can, just press the like, that's the heart button, just at the bottom left-hand corner of this screen. And yes, johncnduk.org, and I think a few other things. Let's see what happens in the next few years. And great demonstration. My hands are frozen because I've been. I think I've got a metal tripod here, or it's in fiberglass, but it's very, very cold. So now I'm gonna see if I can get a hot chocolate somewhere. Right away. But it was a very. It was a great, great demonstration. Thank you. I know I should really buy fingerless gloves or maybe one of these tripods here. It looks really good. I'll see if I can find some people that I know. I think they may have left the mayor left already. As soon as Corbyn came, the crowd did go wild, and then when once he finished, it's actually very good. It's like, you know, he wrote a speech. He memorized it. Very good. Like people like him, it's like wow, they are wonderful people. In any case, hi Martin. I'm not sure about what the crowd size was, but Trafalgar Square was full, and that Trafalgar Square can take about 5,000 people. Then after that, the overflow was in so I don't know. Like, I would say conservatively, I would say, but I don't know what else I can say. That's from where I was standing. So I permit the words that was. You can see it. Yeah, it's still there. They would probably be able to estimate it more. But then they did point out to me during a quarter of a million people. Marching. So hopefully with people like them, there were actually three, the Green Party, SNP, and the Fad Kumri here as well. So there might be more people turning up. Oh, no, that's okay. Anyway, see if I can actually find everybody else. I will start uploading this. So please, thank you so much. Well, you know, already have any spare shillings, always you can have what I believe, yeah, the PayPal account there, nemogbr@yahoo.co.uk. We can always use the assistance and to upgrade our equipment. And yeah, just general way to actually make sure I'll get to you. I think that's it. Ah, fantastic. Yeah, I would say tens of thousands. I don't know how many people actually end up staying though, because a lot of people did march, then I don't know if they wanted to stay. It is really freezing at the moment. It's actually really bad. Okay, hello.
Hi, we stood next to each other at the climate change rally. I was in the choir. How's it going?
It's good, actually. We had a lot of people actually watching, but they were actually not much.
Well, we did two.
Okay, because I did see a few. It would have been nice if I actually had stayed put, but then I wasn't.
Okay, we didn't stay put. Anyway, this is...
Thank you. All right, guys, thank you so much for, again. But great atmosphere. Maybe they would have... nothing wanted. Anyway, okay, peace out. See you later. Be safe, guys. I shall see you soon.